George Kerr to serve. Love all.
So Darko Jorgic starting off with the backhand serve. Get into the rally.
One, love.
Fast and long to the backhand side and an outright service point for the Seaman.
Two of the best backhands in the world right now. Different kind of backhands, but very, very dangerous.
One, oh.
Playing with the change of pace game here. Harimoto not going directly for speed into that backhand.
A lot of the crowd excited to see Harimoto showing out here.
Two, one.
It is a cool thing. It's a bit of a concert, really, to get to hear his vocals and watch him in his fight. A warrior at the table.
100%. And there's some people out there that think Harimoto is disrespectful. It's just about how much he values each point, and he's as fair as they come.
Yeah, super polite. You'll see it.
Three, two.
And in day-to-day life, too. I mean, he's just as gentle as can be.
Yeah, for sure.
That said, nothing gentle on the table here. A massive force. That said, he's very good in the blocking game and has that control to slow the ball down. He does that to tie it up.
And Darko just signaling to his coach there that the ball kind of kicked up quite surprisingly.
4-3.
Good subtle serve here. The pendulum from Tomokazu Harimoto. Dong Qiming, coach in the corner.
Fight.
And you can feel the difference in this rally. It's Tomokazu on top of the bounce, controlling, and Darko trying to put in that bigger backhand from a bit behind the table. Makes the first one, goes for the second one on the parallel. I've had a lot of looking down at the equipment. High humidity here.
4-5.
And I feel like in the beginning of the match, we're going to see a bit more control taking these sort of spinnier shots. But as the match develops and humidity gets higher within each individual, they're going to be a little bit more flat and drive a bit more.
6-4.
Clips the net there. I feel like Harimoto's game is a little bit more rigid than Darko's in some way. He's got an amazing game, but I feel like Darko can win in different ways.
That's one of them, probably the crispest forehand I've seen from Darko in some time.
Just to elaborate on that, I feel like there are more ways Darko can win a point than Harimoto. I feel like he's more comfortable in the rally. Harimoto likes to get it finished as soon as he can.
5-7.
The word rigid is probably the right description. I know what you mean, and I feel like as Tomokazu Harimoto's developed over the years, he's found more ways. And while he does like to finish the point quickly, he's also comfortable to block a bit and sort of earn the opportunity. So it is that fine balance. He's becoming more versatile with more robust set of skills. Down the line as quick as can be, and Darko Jorgic within 1 point now.
Pinning that wide forehand. Amazing short strokes. Harimoto sometimes can go a bit passive on the forehand block, although his forehand in general is much improved.
7-0.
Good change of placement on the serve. Jorgic goes deep to the backhand in the first point of this match. As the French team, the LeBron brothers, watch on, they will study their European counterpart. It's going to be really tough for Harimoto to block if he has to deal with pace like this coming back as wide as it is for the next ball.
The Darko Sparko. It's a knockout shot. Now, Darko Jorgic's forehand is quite divisive. He likes to play the slow, loopier spins and take it a little bit later. So Harimoto is trying to pin him in the middle there, and it worked a treat.
Forced into a bit of fishing here, but he taps his head. Darko Jorgic, I think he felt like he had better options in this moment. Quite frankly, the third ball didn't feel like he came into it the way he would have wanted. We see a lot of this with some of the players recently, making that first ball really count.
Eight,
following
five.
Their serve like there's no tomorrow and trying to recover to get back, knowing that there is. Beautiful counter here, and it sets up two game points for Tomokazu Harimoto in the first game. Third towel break. Frazier, he's got you practicing your backhands. What are you thinking?
It's the way he comes into it. It's the way he harnesses his energy and then just expels it into the backhand. Zippy. I mean, when you walk into the training hall, which we have the pleasure of doing sometimes, you can really see how much he's working on that 1-1 combo with his backhand side.
Fascinating point here. Tomokazu Harimoto takes the game.
Let's have a look. I mean, I think we're going to see him getting a little bit more vocal here.
Well, this time he made the same fishing shot that he had missed twice in the business end of last game. But it's the bigger shot that seems to be more of his staple. That counter.
Wow. I mean, we know like Alexi Lebrun in some ways. Darko isn't afraid to give himself a telling off just to get rid of that negative energy. Perhaps slowing things down a little bit more. Harimoto likes it quick, so slow down the pace. Test him in and out.
Love three.
A lot of the looking down at the equipment. Again, it's at 95% humidity over the freeway. And Alexi Lebrun in the background there, you'll have a chance to see after a little bit of a sit out. As his opponent had a walkover, he had a walkover over Lin Winru because of the hand injury, so we haven't seen Alexi in some time. Jorgic down by two after the start. Some good spin here from Tomokazu Harimoto.
Kicks right up after it bounces on Jorgic's side and he mistimes the backhand. That ball goes to infinity and beyond. Harimoto is doing a lot of float serves here.
Yeah, if you're newer to table tennis, less rotation on that ball, what we call a float serve, can lead to a popped up receive if it looks like heavy underspin and earn you a good third ball attack, as it did.
2-5.
Nice tight serve near the baseline of the table. Jorgic, a bit more traditional here.
If Jorgic wants to open up, he'll probably play the serve with backspin if he wants a loose flick. I think he's going to serve with a bit more topspin. Hard to play a flick winner off this serve.
As quick as can be right down the line, Coach Oystershek Uğur, who's been with him since he was 5 years old, offering support like a mother figure, really.
Six, three.
I think it's good that Jorgic has some feminine energy, sort of some calming influence in the corner. Because he can be a bit of a hothead, but he will fight till his last breath, as he did against Liang.
It's a good point. There's a nice balance there, something to keep you level, keep you focused, and at your best performance. That is the coach's job, after all. Whether it's words of tactical advice, comfort, reminders, encouragement, whatever it takes.
Five, six.
And this time we see little to no hesitation on both wings from Darko Jorgic, reminding us that he does have those big attacks when he needs. Oh, it's so low.
Come on. Six.
Beautiful backhand again. This one just spraying it out wide. Covers the middle well to do this and still finds the angle.
This topspin serve is working a treat. He's inviting the flick, but it's tough to flick. Really, really aggressively. And Jorgic there, you can see playing the backhand from more of the middle position, can do that. It's usually a more European thing, I think.
Seven, six.
Harimoto fighting, goes up by one here with that shallow spin shot from under the table on the forehand. Back edge of the table, just nicks it.
That could be massive. Look at the score, the difference there between 7-all and 6-8.
Remember, Darko Jorgic trailing in this match so far, down 0-1 in games. in at the table. He quickly hops forward, and those backhands set him up. It's the forehand to finish. It's going to take all the ingredients here to make this work. Look at Jorgic here. He's pulling that right foot out of the way to play from the middle, the forehand. Nice change.
Next. 8-7.
This is the only men's singles quarterfinal where a Chinese player is not involved.
Yeah, I was looking at the WTT post last night, and we've got ourselves some very interesting matches to come, interesting draws to look at.
7-9.
A big, big streak of points here for Darko Jorgic. I love rolling the tongue when I say his first name, man.
Sneaks one past here. Tomokazu Harimoto. Coach Kunihito Tase there in the crowd alongside some of the other team members for Japan. You can see the frustration settling in a bit for Jorgic. Oh, and a little bit coming back. He did catch the edge earlier, and the net here to help him out sets up two game points for the Slovenian sensation.
An absolute P-roller. Wow.
Zhangbun Jiao, that's Harimoto's name in China. Zhangbun, that is.
What does that translate as?
I
think that's just the characters of his name. His parents are both from China. Okay. So he also has a Chinese name at birth, as many do when their parents are from China.
9.
And a game point saved here.
You can't complain, Jorgic, about that little net there.
Right, he had a few already, a few IOUs he had given over. Start to think back to yesterday, Dima and Ugo. My goodness. Jorgic makes it happen. The big backhands finish the deal here. 11-9. Harimoto on the receive.
One.
The first point with the spinny backhand inside the table. When you put it up against the backhand of Jorgic in the rally, it doesn't feel quite as powerful, but it is one of the best backhand receives in the game.
An
extra power on the forehand. Again, we see that where a player comes out making their first attack really count.
The transition is harder to make if you have to lift a backspin ball and then come over the top of a topspin one. So I think both players could push a little bit more often, if possible, into the backhand side first.
1-3.
The element of surprise is going to be such a crucial moment. Pushes can be dangerous, especially long ones, if the opponent's in position. Generally, as long as it's quality, attacking first is to your advantage. They both agreed on that pretty quickly. The crowd, it's amazing the eyes of these players. Even in the replay, it was quite faint, tough to see. Harimoto off to a good start. What are you thinking?
He's protecting the forearm with the backhand side. Harimoto there, which is pressuring Jorgic to play it down the line.
4-2.
Such a combination player, Tomokazu. I feel like he's got a big plan before each point, but Jorgic, I feel, is a bit more free.
It's interesting. I was thinking of if Ma Long is a combination player, which he definitely is, you think it might be the right way to go, but combinations obviously come into play. But in terms of freedom, Alexis LeBron, it just seems like everything, he just reacts so quickly that he starts fresh every single shot and has a new idea. So 72% Tomokazu Harimoto converting serves to points. Right at baseline, just wide on this one. Harimoto is good against the lobs. has one of the most successful drop shots I've ever seen against lobbers. But it's been some time since I've seen it happen because almost nobody lobs to Tomokazu anymore.
Three, six.
Yeah. And he's good at coming through flat, isn't he, as well? He can slap the ball, Hamamoto. Doesn't seem to do it as much now as before.
Seven, three.
I think if it's sent to his wide forehand and he's on the move, he'll do it from time to time. But yeah, I think he's put on a lot of weight and muscle that's allowed him that extra topspin. For me, this was a big step for him in becoming more successful against Team China.
Seven, four.
When you compare Tomokazu's game and those punchy shots and the flatter shots that he used to play more, and then you compare him to Fan Zhendong, for example, Fan Zhendong seems to be able to drive and keep topspin on almost everything, short stroke or long. That adds
five,
security.
Seven.
Makes your shots higher percentage. Even under pressure behind the table, it gives you a better chance to really be a threat. So I think that's part of the reason Harimoto's hit the weight room so hard from the time he was about 14 years old.
Because before he was just a skinny kid with good timing. Now it's different.
Five, eight.
Well said. Tomokazu with a big point to step back, take control after a few here from Darko Jorgic.
Nine, five.
Not letting Jorgic get into the swing of things. A lot of oomph on that receive.
Five.
Haven't seen an attempt like this. Jorgic behind the table tries adding side spin there with backspin on the push game, and now it's 5-game points for a 2-1 lead. Harimoto takes it with authority here, 11-5.
One,
we talk about float serves, the variation in the spin game. I think Harimoto's doing wonderfully to change up every serve. A bit more spin on this one.
A little bit more, but still fairly floaty. I mean, it's really hard to flick a float ball with a lot of topspin. Also, it's very hard to dig a float ball with a lot of backspin.
Tomokazu having won 12 of the last 16 points before this one here. Jorgic, we've seen him come back from 0-2 down. He's got his chances here. It couldn't have been played better from Harimoto. I mean, it was just everything done right. A fast long serve, quick third ball attack, follow up on the parallel. Jorgic keeping the pressure on, still deflected and saved by Harimoto.
Four,
clever, crafty serve, so wide there from Harimoto.
Heavy spin four. Here to protect a nice long push, loaded with underspin.
Maybe see some more of those topspin pendulum serves from Jorgic. Just going back to the backhand from the forehand side.
Three, four.
A momentum switch all of a sudden here.
Yeah, right out of his timeout. A little bit of top spin, a whole lot of side spin there. And a nice follow-up.
Four, four.
Oh, it is too pretty. Illegally beautiful out here. Nothing illegal about it, just the speed. It seems like he could get a ticket for something like this. It is so fast right down that line.
Five, four.
Body language there. It seems like he's trying to keep himself weight forward into the table.
Weight forward and shot forward. Drop the bat a bit too much there.
Five, four.
Done well. Done really well in that position.
Right. From behind the table, saves a net ball, uses the spin very effectively to secure his shots. Tied up now. It's a very uncomfortable ball. Smart, slower pace here as Harimoto leaves the ball placed shallow and on the backhand side. It's way out in front of Jorgic in that rally.
Four,
This pattern we've seen many times. One big forehand. Hatimoto blocks soft to the wide backhand. And then the fishing shot from Darko Jorgic. We got a timeout now from Tomokazu Hatimoto. The way he springs up into that ball from behind the table causes some serious trouble. No timeout. Just a little bit of music on the towel break there. Nothing like a good old sexy towel break for the fans. But this serve is too good and earns Hatimoto a wonderful opportunity. Jorgic quickly put on his heels after that serve read issue.
Because it comes at you so quick, it's hard to really get the bat in the right position. And then it's float two, and then he just hacks it with backspin. It's constantly changing. It's just harassing to play against.
It's funny, Darko Jorgic let out quite a roar, but you couldn't really hear it. The timing was just perfect. It's, again, like those theater masks.
Yeah.
The agony and the celebration at the same time on opposite sides of the table. 1 point game here. Oh, smart placement. Completely shuts down and diffuses that Bomba backhand of Darko Jorgic. Watch him get ready. He was going to turn for a forehand, it seemed, rather. Either way, he had an explosive shot waiting, but the placement perfect. Extra spin, and it is three match points for Tomokazu Hatimoto. Really had to work hard for that shot.
He did, and this win, if he can get it, is going to mean so much to him. Getting his revenge against the man who knocked him out of his home Olympics.
And he does it. Tomokazu Hatimoto looks up to the skies above. 11-7.